The names, emails, driver's license numbers of 57 million riders and drivers were exposed. Uber paid, as you said, it was $100,000 in hush money to the hackers and hid the breach from the public and regulators for a year. Now, drivers are only now just finding out whether or not they were affected. I spoke to Harry Campbell. He's an Uber driver in L.A., and he did have data stolen. He sent me this screenshot of an alert he received from Uber today after submitting his information on the website they have subsequently set up. Now, the broader fallout, though, has been swift. Today, a key Democrat has called for a FTC probe into Uber's handling of the breach. The FTC was already looking into the company, and experts say that the cover-up could potentially open Uber up to criminal liability. And the FTC actually just now responding, saying that it is closely evaluating the serious issues raised from Uber hiding that breach. Now, a lawsuit has also been filed by a user accusing the company of negligence, and the New York Attorney General's office yesterday opened an investigation into the matter. The fallout has also extended overseas, with the UK's information commissioner expressing, quote, huge concerns. But guys, one of the most important impacts this could have on the company itself is in its negotiations with SoftBank. This is a deal that would raise billions of dollars and make major governance changes. In a blog post yesterday, new CEO Dara Khosrowshahi wrote that he won't make excuses and he can't erase the past, but he commit to learn from Uber's mistakes. The problem is that that list has not stopped growing since he took up the position just over 2 months ago. Guys, back over to you.
Dee, it's not stopped growing, but is he getting these issues out early enough that it's not really on his plate? It's not a mark against his record and perhaps just another mark against Travis Kalanick?
It may be, and I'm told that Travis Kalanick did know about the breach, but he handed over to his chief security officer, who was fired earlier this week, Joe Sullivan. It may not be. The responsibility may not lie with the new CEO, Dara Khosrowshahi, but this is still yet another problem that he has to deal with when he's supposed to be shoring up Uber's business. Remember that Lyft has been making inroads this year. It has a reputation problem. It has a problem with drivers. So these are all just many, many more distractions for him.
And the impact as well on that upcoming London hearing, which I think the next one's on the 11th of December, will certainly be interesting to watch. Dee, thank you.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.